Hello, hi everybody. So it is the last day of January, and it dawned on me that I should try to vlog the end of this month, beginning of this next month, because I am going to start House of Flame and Shadow tomorrow. I'm finishing my January read, so I wanted to squeeze a few more things in by the end of the month after Kingdom of Ash because it took so much time of the month for me to read. So I grabbed a few short books, Alone with You in the Ether, which I will do in my January wrap-up, and then I am currently finishing What You Are Looking For is in the Library, and I love this book. It is exactly what I needed right now after that, like, insanely epic story. This is just light, and it's really tugging at my heartstrings. It's kind of just a bunch of short stories about humanity and human nature, and... What? Yeah. Anyways, I will also talk about this in a January wrap-up as well. Long story long, I was like, we're finishing January, starting February. I think I'm going to vlog my reaction to starting House of Flame and Shadow and my reaction throughout the weekend and like what I get to. I'm going to keep it spoiler-free. If I do have any spoilers, I will make sure I disclaimer because I don't play that game. Cozy weekend vlog, I'm thinking. Well, wrapped up on the couch with a blanket, cup of coffee, and some Sarah J. Maas, which is really how I like to spend my time. Yeah, I will see you guys this weekend. Thanks for joining me on this journey for House in Flame and Shadow. Here we go. Everyone, it is Thursday morning. It's just before six. So I'm on the couch with a cup of coffee and also House of Flame and Shadow. It has begun. I grabbed it as soon as I sat down this morning, and I just cracked it open and just started reading it, so I haven't gotten very far. I am immediately thrown back into the world, and I am so excited to see what happens in this book. But I've actually seen some really good commentary. Nothing spoiler-ish, but people saying how the book is like already their favorite out of the entire series, and it's moving really quickly and a lot is happening, so it's making me pretty excited about it. Anyways, Thursday morning check-in, going to sit here for a while and get as far as I can into the book before I have to log into work. And today is a big editing day before hopefully my next video is coming out tomorrow. I'm gonna work, edit. I will read throughout the day wherever I can and take it from there. I'll check in with you guys later. So here we are back again on the couch, ready to crack on with this book, try to make some headway. I mean, update right out of the gate. I'm impressed because it picks up exactly where it left off, which was what I was hoping for. I sometimes hate in a series where one book ends and you go into the next one and it seems like you've got this taste in your mouth. You know what happened in the last book, the previous book, and then sometimes they like do this really big build up to get you back to where the last book ended. And I'm like, but I've been waiting. I've been waiting for so long to find out what happens. So can we just get on with it? Happy to report it picks up quite literally where it left off. So yay for that, Sarah J. Maas. I've got some quiet time now. I'm gonna try to make some headway on this book. Can't wait to see what else happens. And I will be updating you guys through the weekend as I go on. A little bit of reading time. I'll check in with you guys later.
Friday afternoon check-in, I made a little bit of headway this morning on House of Flame and Shadow. Not as much as I wanted to. I ended up getting stuck coaching later than normal this morning, so I didn't get as much reading time before starting my day job, which, gosh, like the job, it just gets in the way every day. Ugh. Anyways, it is Friday afternoon now, though, wrapped up working, and Mel Reeds is actually going to go into a sprint at 5 p.m. my time, which is in just under an hour. Funny enough, my husband was like, I want to stop at the bookstore really quick to see some, I want to look at some ideas for what I'm going to read next. And I was like, that's fine. I'll just grab a little Starbs, a little iced coffee. And as I was at Starbucks in Barnes & Noble, they were like, hey, if you buy something from the cafe, you can get this book for $5. This is on my TBR. And I almost bought it last weekend. $5. So I was like, okay, coffee and a book. I mean, every time I'm here. I'm really excited about the sprint because I try to use the sprints. I know they're for like productivity and basically just a set aside time for you to get some stuff done. I am legitimately going to try to use it for reading. I love reading sprints for that reason. You can kind of just put it in the background, you zone out, you grab your book, and you get stuff done. So I have grabbed my coffee, I've grabbed my book, I'm set up, like I'm posted up in the bedroom. I think I'm going to chill for the rest of the afternoon during the sprint and just try to get as much reading done as I can. Update on where I'm at so far. I mean, I love it. I don't know if I can say that it's my favorite so far out of all three books. However, I'm not that far into it. As I said previously, I love that it picked up exactly where it left off. So it doesn't even really feel, the only lag I felt is the time that I had to wait for the third book to come out. So it picks up basically exactly where it left off. And all of the characters are in play, like from the start of the book. So that part I truly enjoy. Of course, I want to see what happens. If you have read book two and you know how it ends, that's kind of what I'm talking about. This afternoon's plan is to buckle down, join in on the reading sprint. Other than that, I'm super excited that I also got this book for $5 today. I can't stop talking about it. Like, I don't know. I think it's a real sign of being an adult. I've said this to myself before. I'm like, I knew I was an adult the day I started saying like, oh my gosh, guess how much I bought this for? It was such a bargain. Anyways, I will check in with you guys later. I might do a late night check-in or a Saturday morning check-in. Or if you would really like to join me on this journey, join Mel Reed's. Her reading sprints are some of my favorites. If you already joined those, then I guess I'll see you there at 5 o'clock. And if not, I will check in with you guys later. Bye! Good morning. Happy Saturday, my lovely reader friends. We are here to check in on my progress of House in Flame and Shadow. So, a couple of thoughts so far. First and foremost, do I like it? Yes. However, I just got to part two of the book. So, this book is broken into different parts or sections. And the first 200 or so pages was kind of slow moving, kind of a build up, I think, to what's really going to be starting now in the story, which is okay, but it did feel like it was dragging a little bit, in my opinion. So as I said yesterday in my check-in, it does pick up with all of the characters where they left off, so I really appreciate that. The multiple POV is written mid-chapter. And for the life of me, I can't remember if the second book did that or not. And I'll have to pull it out and look through it. It's almost kind of confusing for me. So it's not like a POV will change by chapter. It will be in the middle of a chapter. So I'll get done reading something about Bryce, and then all of a sudden something will be happening with Hunt
in the next paragraph, and it's like a jump scare. I'm like, it's like almost really quick for my brain to understand what's happening. I guess I will get more used to it as the book goes on. Again, I'm like having a really hard time remembering if the second book was like that or not. And if it was, I don't even recall, obviously. So it must not have been that big of a deal. If I'm being honest, the POV from Bryce's side, this up until this point, was kind of like lagging for me. I was like, this is kind of like, I almost wanted her point of view sections to end so I could get back to the other characters. And I was like, that's weird. She's like my favorite character out of this whole book. But with that being said, already in the first part of the book, I'm seeing some of these other characters come forward, and I really like that. So I think we are going to see a little bit more from Therian in this book, and also Ethan in this book. One of my favorite parts about Crescent City is the amount of species there are, I guess you could say. So it's not just Fae, though I love reading about Fae and fairies in books. I like that Crescent City has so many different types of species. So you have Fae, you have archangels, you have merpeople, you have wolves. I think it's really interesting to see things from these different types of point of views. So each one, like each of these characters works a little differently, like the merpeople or the river people have different ways of living than like the wolves do and the fae do. I am really enjoying it so far. Like I said, the first part felt kind of a little slow. I'm not kidding. As soon as I flipped the page and it said like part two and I started reading, I was like, whoa, I feel like we're moving now. This is what I like. That's my check-in for Saturday. I am about to get ready. I'm having some more coffee. I'll get ready for the gym, maybe read a little bit more before I leave, and then also reading more this afternoon. I don't know how long I'm going to make this vlog. When I first started, my intention was just like through the weekend and my initial reactions. But now I'm like, do I just go through the whole book? I don't know. Because I don't know yet if I'm going to break the book up. So I usually like to, if I have a very large book like this, especially again, one with like multiple characters and lots of tracking of what's going on, I'll sometimes get about halfway through the book, give my brain a little bit of a break and jump into something else, or just read something in tandem along with this. So I don't always know how long a book is going to take me to get through is the thing. So I'm like, do I just make this a weekend vlog of my thoughts so far, or do we go through this entire book together? I'm going to think on it, but I will check in with you guys later. Bye! Hello, besties. Checking in on Sunday and my progress on House of Flame and Shadow. I am down in the studio right now because I'm actually going to start recording for my January wrap-up video, and I thought I might as well jump into this first since I have been reading this morning. You know what? I'm just under halfway through, and I am in it to win it for this book. I will risk it for the biscuit. I love it. Love it. I stand by my statement yesterday about how the first part of the book, so part one, is a really big buildup. It did seem like it dragged a little bit. However, now that we are in part two, it is like sailing. Like we are doing the things and the people are peopling. You know what I mean? Anyways, I really do enjoy this, and I'm very quickly reminded why I like Sarah J. Maas as a writer. Does she kind of have a template to how her characters work? Yes, but that's what I like about it. I almost know what I'm going to get with her writing. So your female character is smart and conniving and witty, and she can hold her own, and she's seen some things and been through some shit, right? And that's really what I like about it. I like these strong female leads. I like these females that are queens and that are basically bowed down to by the men in their lives. Like these men realize how amazing these women are. I like that she always has a group. So like there's so many side characters in her stories. And we're learning even more about the characters from this book already in book three. We have these templates of having like a very strong female lead and then either like her main love interest or whatever he is. So we know we're going to get that. But I think it's the side characters that also bring everything together. You can look back at any of her series like Throne of Glass and be like,
Oh my God, I just loved Dorian so much. Like, he was always my favorite, or I am a Manon fan since day one. So stuff like that, right? The side characters of these stories kind of really help bring everything together and give them so much volume. I don't know. It's enjoyable. I love it. I feel like I'm stumbling over my words a lot today too, and I don't know why. So anyways, yep, I'm just about halfway through, just under halfway. So I'd like to make a little bit more headway today, and I'm getting through it faster than I typically would for a book of this size. I just can't read that fast. So I'm excited that I feel like it's moving along and it's moving quickly. And it's the first part was a little bit hard for me to absorb. Like, have you ever been reading a book and you feel like your brain is not like, it's not like going in, like you're reading the words, but you're not quite absorbing all of the information. The first part felt a little bit like that to me, but I will say, I think that was my own doing. I did not do a reread of the second book, which looking back, I think I should have. I'm like, I remember it. There's no way I wouldn't remember all the things. I loved that book. There's just so much that happens in a book of these substantial sizes. I should. That was my bad. I should have gone back and probably reread the second book because I read it as soon as it came out and I haven't read it since. So there's been a lot going on in my brain in the last year. So again, that was, I feel like that was kind of my fault on that. I might check in with you guys tomorrow. I don't know. Again, I don't know what this vlog is going to be like. This is just a random vlog of my thoughts and opinions on House of Flame and Shadow so far. Like, you probably haven't seen enough of those on the internet already. I'm just a Sarah J. Maas fan. I am. When a book first comes out, there's like this revamp of how we feel about a certain author. And there's a lot of negative about her online, which again, I don't even really care that much. I think that that's the beautiful part about this online community, is having a space to talk about your own thoughts and opinions, especially on books and authors. But I also want to bring up some good stuff. I like watching things sometimes where I'm like, yeah, girl, I like it too. I feel you. This is completely honest. Like, I'm trying to say, I wasn't sure in the first part of the book, but now I feel like it has significantly picked up and I'm like, yep, I remember. I remember why I like Sarah J. Maas. I feel like there are a lot of people who are very strong in their opinions about their dislike for her and her writing. And I wanted to bring it back a little bit with someone who does enjoy her writing. Can confirm, do enjoy. So with that being said, this could be the last bit of our vlog together. I could check in a little bit this week as I start to wrap it up. TBD on that. Either way, I hope you guys have had a lovely weekend. I hope you got lost somewhere magical in your books, and I will check in with you later. Bye. Hi, hello. Happy Tuesday to everybody. I did not check in yesterday. It was quite a busy day, and I did get some reading in, though, which was the most important part. Obviously, out of the entire day. But I coached this morning, got some work done, and I have to coach again this afternoon, and it's looking kind of quiet, so I think I'm going to sit down and get a little bit more reading done, and then go from there. So I'm chipping away at the book quite well, if I do say so myself. I think I only have like 200 pages or so left of the book, so I, for me, am making quite a bit of headway on it, and I'm very happy with that. I think what we're gonna do is sit down, probably have a little caffeinated drink to, you know, set the mood. Back to coaching later, and then reading this evening, if I'm lucky, and if I can keep my eyes open, because I have been up since 4 a.m. So, yeah. All right. I will check in with you guys in a bit. Taking a break to get outside and
get a little sunshine, because when there's sun in the winter in Michigan, you jump on the opportunity to absorb it. So I'm outside with the puppy. There he is. Dash. Hi. What's up? Sorry for all the background noise, because there's like construction going on in the neighborhood and other neighborhood dogs barking, but I wanted to give an update on the book because I didn't really say much earlier, and I did get to sit down and read for a little bit. I absolutely love it. It felt like the first part of the book, so literally part one, because it's broken into sections, was really slow moving. I felt like there was more going on with the side characters of the book. Like, even though they didn't really get very far, as in like they didn't go anywhere, but it felt like there was more like actually happening with them. So anyways, I've been in part two. I finished part two, and it was like 0 to 60. Like, we hit the ground running, and a lot has happened. I know there's a lot of unpopular opinions about Bryce as a character, but I love Bryce. And also because I have read Throne of Glass, and she's really just kind of like a, I don't want to say a copy and paste of Aelin, but she's so similar to Aelin, where she has like that. She's super cunning and kind of conniving, and she'll do what she has to do to get shit done type of girl, which, you know what? I kind of appreciate that. I actually so far think I like this better than book two. Book one, I absolutely adored. Book two, we had so many characters introduced, and I think that was the whole point. It was kind of like building just for more world building, more character building, where you get introduced to so many people and what those people will bring to this kind of like revolution or rebellion, I guess, against the Asteri. So definitely a building book. I liked book two, but I think I like book three even more. And I am so far in part three of book three. I can't wait to see where it goes. I have about 200 pages left, and I will just keep updating you guys as I can. All right, catch you later.
Please don't mind the awful lighting and the nighttime situation that we have happening here, but I had to turn the camera on and do just a quick little blurb, because remember how I was like, oh my gosh, I love how this book is so made up of like side characters and getting to know them more and all these things that I absolutely love. And something big just happened for one of the side characters. Like, I want to say it's out of the blue. Maybe not out of the blue. I don't know. It was like it accelerated way more quickly than I thought that it was going to. I was just like, okay, I'm on board with that. I mean, it's really hard to do this non-spoilery. Like, I just want to tell you the things that are happening. If you have not read this, then it's a big spoiler. But if you have read this, and I don't know, maybe it's still not making sense. I just wanted to like turn the camera on and like capture the emotion that I am feeling. I'm here for it. I like it. I think it's going to make a big difference in what continues to happen towards the end of this book. And there's not much left, so I want to see what else happens. Like, where is this going to end? I'm very curious. All right, that's it. I just wanted to do a quick check-in. Bye. Do you want to go to the store with me? You do? What? Oh. Okay, you ready to come with Mama? Yeah, you want to come with Mama? I love you. Okay, so we were making an errand run before we go back to reading. Little man here loves a car ride, so it's a real special treat when he gets to go to the grocery store with Mom. Do I love this book? Yes, I love this book. Is it my favorite? I don't think so. Book one, I think, still stands as the favorite. Do I like this more than book two? I think I do. So there's that. Bryce is like pretty damn hard on Hunt. I think that she is that typical Sarah J. Maas female, which we do know and love. So, you know, kick ass, take names, take no shit from people. But she's kind of giving him a hard time because it seems like he's got a little bit of PTSD. Like, Hunt has been around for a while, you know? I mean, when you're half an angel, you've lived quite a while. And he's been through some things. And he's got some trauma that he's trying to work through. And she's like, I'm gonna need you to figure that out so that you can help me fix everything. So, don't know if I love that. I thought about it. I was like, if the tables were turned here, like if this was a man doing that to a woman, I would be like, excuse me, sir. You need to calm down and let her heal. That I don't necessarily love. Do I still love Bryce as a main character? Absolutely. I find her funny. I just think she's a little hard on Hunt. He is like, I will literally bow down and kiss the earth that you walk on. And she's like, perfect. I'm going to need your help. So there's that. But other than that, the side characters in this book have truly made it this book. So first of all, Therion is just like out of this world. Amazing. Like this guy cracks me up because he comes off like pretty arrogant and kind of cocky, but also he is such a big-hearted, well, I was going to say person, but I guess he's a mer person. Mer? Man? He's a mer person. He is the first one to step in when somebody needs help. He's like, I got you. I will get myself in like some deep shit just to make sure you are okay. And I love that about him. Rune has really come forward in this book, not just like with the actions that he's taking. Well, yes, with the actions that he's taking, but also his personality. So he's opening up a lot, and I love that. And I love that we also get him in this book too, because it was kind of hard to tell from book two where he was like, how he was going to play a part. Also, don't you love that there's people just walking around my car at the grocery store, like probably thinking, why is this chick videotaping herself? And also Ethan is like, I don't mean to be cheesy, but he's like not a pup anymore. He is a big dog. And if you have read this, you will know what I mean by that. If you have not read this yet, then you will soon find out one day, I'm hoping. So they're kind of like this motley crew of characters at this point, and they are coming to a head now. So all of the plans of action that they have kind of worked out on paper, they're about to step into and try to make this stuff happen. So I am basically at a climax of the book. I've got about 100 pages left. I cannot wait to see where this ends. Is it going to end how I want it to? I don't think so. I think it's going to be a cliffhanger and it's going to rip my heart out, and I'm going to have to wait like a year and a half for another book to come out, because there's just no way this is the last book in the series. And also, I'm curious to see how, if anything else weaves together from what happened at the end of book two, and if that will like play a part anymore in the ending of this book. Again, if you have read these, you'll know what I'm talking about. There is our check-in. We're gonna go for a little walkie because it is a brilliantly beautiful day in Michigan. I don't know what is going on. I'm not gonna complain about it, and I will become a broken record when I start talking about the weather in Michigan. It doesn't matter what time of year it is, I will complain about the weather in Michigan. It's part of who we are as Midwesterners. That's just what we do. I will catch up with you guys later. This is really turning into a week-long reading vlog of my feelings on Crescent City. What do you think so far? He can't read yet. He's only 3. All right, I will check in with you guys later. Bye! Hello, everybody. Welcome to my last and final reading update for House of Flame and Shadow by Sarah J. Maas. I am done. I have finished. I finished this morning. What are my final thoughts on this book? I really liked it. I truly liked it. I have started to see some mixed reviews out there, but I guess that goes for anything. Oh my gosh, isn't reading so subjective like that, which is good and bad? Let me start off by saying what I think my order of this series is so far. So we're 3 books in. I will say book 1, definitely my favorite. Book 3, my 2nd favorite. Book 2, my 3rd favorite. I really liked book 2. I thought it was very action-packed. It introduced us to so many characters that definitely was a setup for book three. So I really did like book two. I did feel like the plot line of that was a little bit much and kind of all over the place. This was a very direct plot line, and I really appreciated that. Where the book started and where it ended made sense. So we were kind of linear through the book, and I like that sort of story. So it was never too hard to understand. Like, you knew what their goal was, what they were going to fight for. The whole point of this book was to see if they could reach that goal or not. I thought I was going to want to break this up with another book, which I do often with larger books, but I didn't want to do that at all. I was that invested in the story. So the book was broken into three parts. Part one was about 200 pages long, and I felt like not a whole lot happened. It was very slow moving. It did set the book up for part two, which kind of felt like it went 0 to 60. Like, once I hit part two in this book, it was like, all right, all engines are firing. We are like full steam ahead. So I did really like that, but I don't think that part one needed to be so long. I just don't think 200 pages was really necessary. I also thought that the pacing of the book after that was very well done as well. This is multiple POV, so you are getting, you know, your point of views from multiple characters. It did throw me off in the beginning because the POV will switch mid-chapter, and that, like, in the first part really was, like, hard for me to wrap my brain around, and then all of a sudden I got used to it, and I didn't even think about it towards, like, after that first part of the book. So that was a little bit different. Usually I'm used to POV switching by chapter, and in this book they were, like, all of a sudden, like, I'm reading Bryce and then all of a sudden it's like Hunt. But it didn't end up making that much of a difference to me in the end. I'm just noting that as kind of the writing style. And I can't remember if the first and second book were like that. I would have to go back and look at them. My final thoughts are, I really liked this. I liked it more than book two. Again, I think book two was just kind of a setup for book three, which sometimes it be that way in fantasy, you know, when there's like five characters that come into play, you have to build the story a little bit. So with that being said, I do think the characters truly made this book. It had that very Throne of Glass-like feeling to it, but in the urban fantasy setting. We all know my love for Throne of Glass. That was a series I think that I will take with me always in my heart. But I started with this series first, and I started with it because it is urban fantasy. If you have not read this yet, and you liked Throne of Glass, keep in mind it will feel different because it is basically that old fae world mixed with our new world surroundings. So if you like the thought of that, I think you will really like the Crescent City series. If urban fantasy is not your thing, Crescent City is just not going to be your thing. That's just, there's no other way around it, around saying that. But because of all the characters, it reminded me of that Throne of Glass feeling where you start to get to know the characters and all of these side characters are there to support her. Do I think she was hard on Hunt in this book? Absolutely. But besides that, she is still like that strong female lead that I always appreciate in Sarah J. Maas writing. And also the side characters were there to kind of drive home this plan of action that they have, that they were like going towards for the entire storyline. I also would love to know if you have read this yet or not. If you have, I want to know your thoughts and opinions on this book. It's clear that I am a Sarah J. Maas fan. I try to stay open-minded though. So just because I'm a fan of hers doesn't mean that I don't want to hear other thoughts and opinions. So if you have started the series, if you've read the series, or if you're questioning whether or not you should read the series, drop a comment below because I want to know about that. Also, if you have made it this far into the vlog, go ahead and drop a wing emoji in there as well, because whenever I think of this, I just think of the angels, which is one of my favorite parts of this whole series. So yeah, if you've made it this far, drop a wing emoji down in the comments section below as well. I want to thank you guys so much for joining me on this reading vlog journey. It ended up being a longer journey than I had anticipated, but you know what? I'm glad that we got to experience it together.
As always, if you liked this video, please take the time to like and subscribe because it always helps a girl out. I am also going to link any way to follow me on social media in the description box below as well. I am also going to include the link to my last video, which was my January wrap-up, where you can see all of the books that I read in January and my babbling thoughts and opinions on those too. As always, it's been an absolute blast, and I can't wait to see you guys in the next one.